Welcome to Labsense Law channel. So we are running identify and study applications of the different laboratory instruments. So in previous lecture we have already covered three topics. Now we will focus on different types of burettes and pipettes. So this is burette and pipette. So you can see in this picture, burette is nothing but these are used for measuring variable quantities of the liquid. They are available in capacities of 1 to 100 ml. They are long graduated tubes of uniform bore and are closed at the lower end by means of the glass top cap. These are used for titration and also to dispense corrosive reagents. Titration we already know, we are performing from I think class 11th only. Then pipettes, these are used for dispensing controls quantities of liquid and are classified as follows. So these are some types of pipettes we can see in this picture. So graduate pipette, then volumetric pipette. So in graduate pipettes there are two types of pipettes. First one is for serological pipettes and second one is for Mohr's pipette. Then first is graduated pipettes. So in graduated pipettes, these are available from 0.1 to 10 ml capacity. The graduation are durable, resistant to chemical attack and normal washing. They are available both in class A and class B accuracies. Class A pipettes are very accurate and are used for quantitative determination. Then volumetric pipettes. So these are some volumetric pipettes you can see in this picture. These pipettes are not graduated but designed specially with the central bulb to deliver specific quantities of the specimen. These pipettes as well as Fallin Ostwald type volumetric pipettes are very accurate for pipetting specimen and standard and also protein free filtrate. Then serological pipettes. So these are some serological pipettes. So you can see in this picture also, these are graduated pipettes marked up to the tip. These are mainly used for pipetting distilled water and reagent only. However, 0.1 to 0.2 ml are used for pipetting specimens like blood, serum, plasma as well as different standard mainly. In next lecture, I will definitely cover blood, serum and plasma, how to demonstrate it in our laboratory. Then it should be handled very carefully because marking start from the tip and even the slight breaking of the tip make major difference and results may affect. Then most pipette. So in this picture, this is the Mohr pipette. These are graduated above the tip so that even if the tip is broken, this can be used to their full capacities. The use is same as that serological pipettes only. However, these are not convenient to perform serological pipette purposes. Okay, so this working is very different than serological purpose. So this is all about today's class. So in next lecture we will definitely cover that plasma sample like that questions and what is colorimeter. Okay, so this is all about today's class. Thank you.